It's time for the Mr. Harry Super Awesome King of Glory Kids Show with your host, Mr. Harry. Yay!
Oh, well, that's not gonna... Can we fold? Oh, no. Oh, it's never gonna get done now. Oh, my. Hi, friend. It's good to see you. Thank you for stopping by the rumpus room. Well, if I haven't met you, friends, my name is Mr. Harry. What's your name? Oh, well, it is so great to meet you. I'm sorry that it, honestly, it's a little messy in the rumpus room right now. School is getting a little busy, and I was cleaning up from the holidays, and I brought out new decorations and things to do, and then I did laundry, and then I started coloring, and then I was learning ukulele, and I had some lunch. I was getting cozy and training. So much was happening, and then I guess I just lost track of it all, and it's really a mess in here, but that's a problem because my mom's coming by the rumpus room today, and do you think she would like to see it like this? I don't think so. So, hey, wait a minute. You're here now, and do you see some mess behind me? Yeah. Could you help me clean this all up? That would be really great if you could help me get ready for my mom, who's gonna stop by. So, I'll tell you what. I would love your help, but I need to go get some cleaning supplies so we can get this all ready to go for my really special visitor. My mom to stop by the rumpus room, so let me go. Let me go grab some supplies, and then we'll get right to work in getting ready. Okay, you stay right here, and I'll be right back, friends. Oh, well, friends, I got a lot of things that I'm thinking are gonna help us get ready here in the rumpus room. So let's see, I have a vacuum. Brought some wipes that we can use. Got some gloves, some towels, and a broom. Why don't I set you there? So, where should we start, everybody? Let's start with the problem right in front of us. That's always a great thing to do. Okay, so let's, you know what? Freddie and Bernie were playing a lot this week, and I lost track of time, so we can put their toy. And we'll put everything in our bag right here. So let's put the toy in the bag. That's one thing put away. And I was trying to learn how to... trying to learn the ukulele, but I think I might need a little more time. So why don't we put that away while we're getting ready? There you go, ukulele. That's a good spot for it. And we'll put the bag away. I can see the table. We're doing a great job getting ready. A sweatshirt. And remember, before we put anything away, we fold it nice and neat. Look at that. You could, that'd make a nice pillow too. That's a great thing to clean up. Okay, so we have some markers. We'll put the markers away. That's a good thing to put. There's also coloring. Got a little distracted with coloring. Let's see, everybody. If we take this away, look, we're all done, everybody. We cleaned up, didn't we? Oh. Well, the table's done. We're not... Oh, there's more... Oh, and this... Oh, no. Oh, you're right. We have a little more to clean up and get ready. So let's see. Let's start. This is one of Mr. Harry's favorite shirts. That does not belong there. We'll hang it up on a hanger over there. That's a good spot for it. And, some things don't look right on our little circle over here. Mr. Sheep doesn't belong there. He was taking a quick nap. We'll clean him up over there. And I think next to our friend Bob, a mug fell over. Let's pick that up. We'll pick up our mug. Oh, that's... Do you know who these toys belong to? These are Freddie and Bernie as well. We'll put them in our bag. And look, we're all done clean. Oh, no. I think I was drying out some of my socks, friends. Do you see my socks? Oh, yeah. Let's put those away. One sock? Two socks? Three socks! That's not enough for two pairs. But we'll clean them on up. Great job. And we have a shirt we can put away. That's a good place to put it. I think my slipper got in my plant, friends. Well, there's a slipper and a lunchbox. Those don't belong there. We'll help get ready. We'll put those away. Let's look at the wall behind us in the rumpus room. That looks great. Let's see the other side now. Oh my. Friends, it looks so wonderful in here. Thank you for helping me get ready for my mom. Oh, taking some time together to get ready. That's really important. And that, oh, it actually reminds me of a Bible story, friends, but I didn't. Oh, I think in cleaning it up, I might have put it away. So let me grab it and we'll talk about it. Let's see. Oh, there it is. Oh, well, friends, I did pack it away in our bag, but look, I found our Bible because getting ready for my mom to stop by the rumpus room, that reminds me of our Bible story for this week. Let's see our new friend that we're going to meet. Oh, there's a lot of friends here. This friend sleeping here, his name is Isaiah, and Isaiah had a really big job from God. God wanted Isaiah to help others get ready for something big. Now, they weren't getting ready by cleaning their rooms and vacuuming and hanging up their sweatshirts. They were getting ready for one of the most incredible and special and unique and amazing people that would ever visit. You know, our story here, who has a picture? I bet you know of him. You know his name. Let's see. You see a special friend here you might know. Yeah. Isaiah was helping God's friends get ready for Jesus. And do you remember what day Jesus was born on? It wasn't Easter. It wasn't 4th of July. It was Christmas. And Isaiah was helping the Israelites get ready for Jesus. Let's think. That was Isaiah, but what about you and me? Can we get ready for Jesus too? Oh yeah, we can. Well, you can get ready for Jesus by loving others. That's a really great way to get ready for Jesus, is by acting like he would. That's helping friends. That's being kind to others. And that's liking and loving people so much that they know Jesus. That's a great way to get ready for him. So thank you for helping me get ready, because it reminded me of our Bible story when Isaiah helped others get ready for Jesus. Talking all about getting ready, there's still a little bit of a mess here. I'll tell you what, let me put this away real quick and I'll be right back. So let me just put this down here. Oh, that's a good spot. Well, friends, thank you so much for stopping by the Rumpus Room today to help me get ready. I really couldn't have done it without your help and your really good eyes to be able to see what had to be done to get ready. And don't forget, everyone, that you can help others get ready for Jesus by loving them and liking them just like he would. That's a great way to get ready for Jesus. Oh, and we can ask him to help us with getting ready for him. So why don't we do that by praying? You can go ahead and get in your prayer positions and I'll start, and then you can repeat it back to Jesus. So, you've got your prayer position? Let's pray today. Dear Jesus, thank you for helping us get ready for your love. We love you, Jesus. Amen. Well, boys and girls, thank you so much again. And now the rumpus room is done, I can go get the rest of the house done by getting ready for when my mom stops by. So thank you so much for stopping by. I'll see you all next week. Let's go.